There, now let's go back inside the mat.
Al, thank you very much. Circumcision is one of the oldest known surgical procedures, but now some people are questioning its medical benefits. NBC's chief science correspondent Robert Bizzell reports on the debate.
Some 3,300 newborn boys get circumcised every day in the U.S. It's one of the most common surgeries in this country. The procedure involves removing the foreskin that covers the head of the penis, usually within 8 days of the boy's birth. In the Old Testament, circumcision is a covenant between God and Abraham, father of Jews and Muslims. It remains a sacred ritual in both religions. But America is the only nation where doctors routinely circumcise boys for non-religious reasons. Worldwide, 15% of boys get circumcised. The circumcision rate in the U.S. is about 60%. Down from 90% in the 1970s. Why the decline? At one time, doctors thought circumcision brought medical benefits, but recent studies have called many of the benefits into question, and increasing numbers of parents are deciding against it. Tom and Nancy Schmidt chose not to circumcise their son Benjamin when he was born 4 months ago.
Once we started looking into the medical facts, checked with our pediatrician, checked with other parents that we respected, we found that there was very little reason to do it.
Why do something you don't need to do? And then with all the, you know, the pain and all that, it seems kind of ludicrous to me.
But for many fathers like John Maselli, having their son circumcised is not a medical decision, but rather a personal and emotional one.
We don't want him to look and ask, why do you look like that, Daddy, and I look like this? We want him to fit in, to feel that he's part of the family, that there's nothing wrong with him, that he's just the same as Daddy.
Dr. George Denniston is president of an organization called Doctors Opposing Circumcision, and Dr. Edgar Schoen is a pediatrician and former chairman of the American Academy of Pediatrics Task Force on Circumcision. Doctors, good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Dr. Schoen, let me start with you. You think for non-religious reasons that newborn boys should be circumcised. Why specifically?
Well, Matt, I think the parents of newborn boys should realize that there is now convincing medical evidence that newborn circumcision has major preventive health benefits, which go on throughout life, analogous to immunizations. Newborn circumcision prevents urinary tract infections in the first year of life, foreskin infections beginning in early childhood, certain sexually transmitted diseases, including HIV in young men and cancer of the penis in older men. Further, when properly performed by a well-trained professional using local anesthesia, newborn circumcision is quick, safe, effective, and virtually painless.
Dr. Denniston, I know you would dispute some of those medical reasons, the prevention of urinary tract infections, penile cancer, sexually transmitted diseases. Why is your information different than Dr. Schoen's information?
Yes, circumcision has no health benefits as far as we're concerned, and the risk of urinary tract infection is only 1% higher in boys who are intact, who are not circumcised. So how can a doctor possibly justify doing 100 circumcisions on a bunch of boys when you might only prevent one urinary tract infection, which is easily treated with antibiotics?
So you're saying the incidence of some of these medical problems is so low that it doesn't warrant or doesn't call for the circumcision of all newborns?
That's right. It couldn't possibly justify it. And cancer of the penis is even more rare, much more rare, so it would require far more circumcisions, and during those circumcisions, some of those boys would die. And we just had a recent death in Cleveland from a circumcision.
But let's mention, that is an extremely rare occurrence.
It's not as rare as you would think. No one knows the exact numbers in America. For instance, in Cleveland, they just took they said it was no longer a circumcision death. They said it was an anesthesia death.
Well, because the surgery was performed to correct a problem with the circumcision, and the young baby did die as a result of general anesthesia.
That's correct.
Dr. Schoen, why is there so much conflicting information here?
Well, Matt, rather than talk about anecdotes and testimonials, I think we should concentrate on the scientific evidence. And there have been multiple studies that show that urinary tract infections, certain sexually transmitted diseases, cancer of the penis, and local infections are prevented by newborn circumcision. As far as complications go, as you said, they're extremely rare. During over 40 years of pediatric practice here at Kaiser Permanente in California, we've done hundreds of thousands of circumcisions. There have been no deaths. In a recent study, in 1996, of almost 10,000 circumcisions, there were no infants that had to be admitted to the hospital for complications of circumcision. But there were 38 uncircumcised infants that were admitted during this one-year period with serious kidney infections. In the first year of life, there is much greater chance you're going to be admitted to the hospital with a serious urinary infection than with a complication of circumcision. So the medical benefits of circumcision far outweigh any risks.
Go ahead. Circumcision, as far as we're concerned, is completely unnecessary. 85% of all the men in the world today are living without being circumcised, and they're living very happily. As far as we're concerned, there are no health benefits to circumcision, and the proof of that is that there is not a single solitary national medical organization in the entire world that approves of routine infant circumcision. And last but not least, circumcision decreases sexual pleasure. And the only men who are really expert at this are men who have been circumcised as adults. And those men say that on a scale of 1 to 10, before it was a 12, and now it is a 3. And so parents, of course, don't want to do anything to...
Dr. Schoen, what about that? I mean, it's an element that we don't like to talk about, but does it decrease sexual stimulation?
Here again, we're talking about anecdotes and testimonials. Actually, medical evidence is to the contrary. A study that appeared in the American Medical Association Journal said that actually uncircumcised older men have more trouble with sexual function than circumcised men. There's no evidence that there's any difference in sexual pleasure. American men who are almost always circumcised have just as much sexual pleasure as Russian men or other men.
It stands to reason that if you remove half the penis foreskin, half the skin on the penis, and that skin holds the nerve endings, which are the major number of nerve endings in the penis, which are related to sexual pleasure, that there are going to be a lot of complications and problems.
Let me ask you a
question about
there's no evidence that there's any difference. As a matter of fact, a study of American women showed that they prefer the circumcised penis by a margin of about 3 to 1, and the reasons were improved cleanliness, that it looked better, felt better, and interestingly enough, 75% of the women thought that the circumcised penis looked more natural.
10 seconds left to just ask for a 5-second answer from each of you.
If circumcision is hygienic, then removing the eyelids is also should be hygienic.
Dr. Schoen?
I don't think you can compare those two procedures, but the evidence now is overwhelming in the medical literature. There are multiple studies that show urinary tract infections, cancer of the penis, HIV and others and local infections are prevented by newborn circumcision.
And let me end it on that. Dr. Schoen, Dr. Denniston, thank you very much both for your opinions.
Thank you.
8:16 up next, a new kind of eyeglasses. That's after these messages.